Welcome to the Plant Spirit Podcast, on connecting with plant consciousness and the healing wisdom of nature. I'm your host, Sara Artemisia, and I am deeply honored to introduce our next guest to the show today. Susan Bowers is an activist and herbalist who's been practicing herbal plant medicine for over 45 years, and her grandmothers are Juanita, Marietta, and Ruth. She lives on the Port Gamble Sklallam tribal ancestral lands, and she lives her life in service to the plants and the earth. In this episode, Susan shares deep wisdom about what it means to be in right relationship with the plants. She also shares about her experience of making medicine with the music of the plants, which is a device first developed at Damanhur in the 1970s and designed to translate the electromagnetic impulses of plants into melodies. So Susan, I am so deeply honored that you were able to join us today, and I'm really excited for our interview. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
This is kind of a dream come true from the very moment that we first connected. It was so clear to me that you are really connected with the plants as a way of connecting directly with spirit. And I so honor that journey that you have been on your entire life. I mean, we were talking right before this interview that consciously for you even started at age 1.5, which is absolutely incredible. So thank you so much for that. I'd like to start out actually by going back to your roots with plants, and really, how would you describe what your relationship with plants is like?
It's like being with family. They're family to me. They live in families and they're sentient. Even the bacteria, as I was telling you, in the soil is sentient. It's a sentient being. All life is sacred and all life is sentient. All of it. The wind, the water. And so it's like being with family, you know, and the music has really brought a new layer to my communication with them.
That's amazing. And so I know that you have been working with this device, the Music of the Plants device, in a way that I've never heard of before. And that I started geeking out with the Music of the Plants device, I think back in like 2006, when I went to a plant spirit gathering in San Francisco when I was living in Berkeley. And that was a revolutionary experience for me to see this small device connected through electrodes to the plant and recognize that the plant was making sounds that were traveling through the electrodes into this device and then out through a speaker that we then experimentally actually hooked up to a massage table. And then there were the healing vibrations were coming through the massage table as people laid on the massage table, and there were different vibrations happening as different people would get on the massage table. So that to me was a revolutionary awakening in that moment of recognizing how plants, not only are they helping us heal on all the physical, mental, emotional, spiritual levels in the ways that they have traditionally been worked with for eons, but also there is this other healing modality that they can also work with, which is the music of the plants. And one of the things that you and I were talking about earlier this summer was how you have been starting to actually incorporate the music of the plants as you are making herbal medicine. So as you are actually going through and making this incredibly potent, spirit-filled, beautiful herbal medicine, you're also playing the music of the plants over that. And it is infusing these sounds of healing into the very medicine that you're making, which when you shared that you were doing that, I was like, I have never heard anyone doing that. That is absolutely amazing. I love it. And so I was curious, can you just tell us a bit about, like, walk us through what is your process of doing that? What do you experience when you are making herbal medicine, when you work with the music of the plants?
Well, the first thing it does is it takes me out of my head, out of the actual process. Oh, I'm cutting the lavender. I've given my offering, I've given my prayers, but when I'm playing my own lavender's plant music, as I harvest it, I've asked for forgiveness. I've asked it to help whoever it's going to go to. And so I harvest to their own music. And I love, like I said, my acquaintance, Shane Mendoza's plant music because I can play lavender then when I'm stripping the plants, when it's in its dried form. I can play that while I'm doing that. And that keeps me in my heart. It keeps me out of my head about, oh, I'm going to bag this up. Oh, who am I going to give this to? It just takes that all away. And I'm really in connection. And then when I'm making salve, I'm playing all kinds of different music, other artists. There's so many out there on the net. But I really resonate with Shane Mendoza's particular music because I can use parsley when I'm doing parsley in the sap or I'm doing different plants. Then I believe, and the plants told me this, they said, play our music while you're cutting us, while you're processing us, and while you're doing your different things. You know, I put it on around the food dehydrator when I'm dehydrating the roots. And I listen. You know, I listen because at my stage in life, I've learned to listen to those spirits, my higher self, whatever you, creator, whatever you, you know, connect with.
I love that.
And I know, like, with them being able to play a Moog synthesizer, which is what Shane Mendoza's music is, they're playing the different instruments on the synthesizer. And I believe with this new added layer that we can, with the plants, develop more deeper relationships to heal ourselves. Mother Earth is fine. She's fine. She takes care of herself. There have been 4 mass extinctions on this planet of humans and plants and animals. And I believe we are in the new paradigm and we're going to make it this time. And if we can connect in that way, we can cause healing for ourselves and our fellow beings on this planet.
You know, what you're saying about the multiple ways that they communicate. I'm curious for you, because you are so connected so deeply with the plants, like obviously you are able to connect and communicate with them through the music of the plants device. I'm also curious, like what other ways do you connect with plants? What other ways do they communicate with you?
I'll be washing dishes. A lot of times you're not doing a specific task with the plants, so making food, whatever. And all of a sudden a message comes in. I got a message last year, to start harvesting a lot of certain plants that make milk. And I'm like, okay, all right, I do it now. Well, then a few months later, my daughter announces she's pregnant. So now I have the medicine for her. So maybe they knew something ahead of time. I mean, that's how it works. It comes in my head as actual messages, and I'm usually busy at something else. I go deeper now when I make the medicine. I go deeper if I have the music on, because then I'm not distracted and I can do my prayer better. You know, it just comes more naturally, the prayer over the medicine.
So does the music to you when you're working with the music of the plants while you're making herbal medicine, does it act as like a focalizer? Like it helps you to really focus in even deeper into the medicine that you're making?
Yes, it does.
That's incredible.
And I just know that vibration is going to go in, and someone who's using the salve or using the tea is going to pick up what they need from those particular plants. I mean, I have a friend that drinks my tea and she said it makes her go to sleep. I mean, I don't know anybody else that it does that for, but for her, it's that medicine is doing what she needs.
Yeah, that's exactly what I experienced when we worked with the music of the plants in San Francisco with that healing massage bed that I was talking about earlier, where as each person laid down on the healing mat and the ficus was connected through the music of the plants to the massage bed, these different vibrational sound qualities would be coming out of the music of the plants device, but they were all kind of a similar type of tonality, but slightly different. But then when this one woman from our group got on the bed, suddenly it dropped like 2 octaves and was a really low, rumbly, consistent sound. And we were all really surprised, like, what is that plant doing with her? Cause that was super, super different from everything that any of us had just experienced. And then, she got off the bed and we were like, okay, what was happening? Like, what just happened there? And she shared with us that she had had back pain in her lumbar for 20 years every day, every moment, every waking moment that she was aware of, she'd had back pain. And in that moment, she was not experiencing any back pain. And so to me, I'm like, yeah, the plants, like you're talking about your friend, like she probably needs to sleep. She probably needs that nourishment, and the plants can help, that they really help us in such, because they are so conscious, they're so sentient. They really know how to work with us in an individual way, which is so special. It's so special. There's something else though, about what you were just talking about that I want to come back to with the music of the plants and your work. Oh yeah. So I experienced this firsthand with a cedar tree that you're really close with, which I just absolutely loved. Such an honor to connect with you in cedar and the music of the plants there on the land that you live on. That's so beautiful. And when you connected the music of the plants device to that cedar tree, it was playing a very melodic, like very smooth integrated sound, which was really different from other experiences I've had with music of the plants that can sometimes be a bit more disjointed or syncopated in their sounds. And I'm curious how you experience the working with plants over time. So for example, I'd imagine you've probably worked with that cedar tree in particular multiple times with music of the plants. And I'm curious, like, how do you experience that evolution of the plants, like becoming aware of their own sound being played, and then how that impacts their music moving forward? Because that was really, really cool to witness with that tree.
Well, you know, I've played it a bunch of times, but I want to make sure that everybody knows is I first ask permission. I don't always get permission. But I ask permission from the tree. I put my heart on the tree. I give gratitude to the tree all before I hook it up. And I think the plants actually is the more you play them, the more their song varies, and they begin to actually play even more in more depth than when I first started. And it's the same with like the rosemary out in the garden, and the house plants that I play, and they get better with practice. An interesting footnote, they were playing music of the plants with a plant concert for a group of people who were all vegan or vegetarian, who love the earth, who love the plants. And when the food came out, all the vegetables and everything, the plant music quit. It quit. And the people were very upset. So they went up and apologized to the plants, but it didn't play again. And so maybe if they'd done that in the beginning, maybe the plants would have, you know, said, thank you. I mean, in my tradition, we're taught that during the Ice Age, the animals gave their lives to us or we would have died. The animal councils got together and said, the humans are going to die. We're going to give our lives. The plants went away under the ice. There were no plants to eat. So we began eating animals. And all they asked is that we thank them. And they told us that in our body, they transmute themselves and go to a higher consciousness. And the plants have told me that's the same thing. When we eat them with respect and acknowledgement that they're sentient, then they help us. That's just a little footnote.
That's a big footnote. I'm so glad you brought that up. I'm so glad you brought that up, because when I first was introduced to the music of the plants device, that was actually my first hang up with it. In my view and understanding, I'm like, the most direct way to communicate with the plants, and everyone has their own way. Everyone has their own way of going in. It's so important for everyone to figure out what is their most aligned way to connect in with the plants. For me, meditating, doing things like working with, flower essences, are taking like a spirit dose drop of tincture, maybe like 3 drops, or drinking some tea and just meditating with the plant, or sitting next to the plant. I love sitting in wild rose bushes and just being totally immersed in that wild rose vibration. It's just so beautiful, soft, loving. So for me, I was like, okay, well, the very most direct way to connect with the plants is just to meditate with them and tune in with who are they. And when I was first introduced to the music of the plants device, that was my beef with it, where I was like, well, does it like having being hooked up with electrodes? Like, does it actually enjoy that? But then bringing in this piece of, okay, asking permission first, like check in with the plant first. Like, does it actually enjoy that? Does it actually want to be engaged in that experience right now? I love that you brought that up, because that's foundational. That is absolutely foundational to everything. Just like with a person, where you wouldn't just hook up a person to electrodes, you know, if they're conscious without their permission, right? Like that would be right. So weird. So yeah. I love that you brought that up. And it definitely brings up this thing for me, because I know you do walk in such deep relationship with the plants, of like, what does it mean to be in right relationship with the plants to you? What does that mean?
It means that we recognize them as sacred and sentient. Like I was saying, down to the insects in the garden, the soil, the worms, the bees, the water, the wind, and recognizing that they live in families like we do. They have children. And if you just go up and pull up their children without permission, you're not going to get the kind of healing that you need. You're going to get the angst. You're going to get that angst. So it's, and also, for instance, sometimes I don't get permission to harvest a plant. It lives its life in my garden and goes to seed. And sometimes it's the seed that it wants to give me, not just its body or its roots. And so it's recognizing that I have two legs. They don't have any. I mean, that's the big difference. They have a brain. Like I said, they dream. And all that is in the cosmos. All of that information, our dreams, their dreams, animals' dreams, all that in, and that's what we're drawing on as healers. We're drawing on that global knowledge and that envelope that surrounds our Mother Earth.
That's beautiful. Yeah.
You don't even have to have a device. You can go on the YouTube and, I don't know, there's a concert I love where a guy, they're playing an orchestra in a vineyard in, I believe, Italy. I mean, it's worldwide. People in every continent are playing plant music, you know, and it's just been incredible. It helps my grandchildren. I've got an ADHD and two ADD kids. And I'm telling you, they ask for me to put it on now or to take them out to the tree when they come.
That's so awesome.
And they calm down and they get focused.
Yeah.
And they feel that love. Like my grandson said, the tree just told me that he loved me. And he said, he, I go, oh, it's a he. Okay. I didn't know. I hadn't gotten that info.
Absolutely incredible that you are sharing this with your grandkids and opening them up to plant consciousness, to plants as sentient beings. That is definitely one of the things that I feel like with the Music of the Plants device, that it can really support with, as well as having all of this incredible healing properties and vibrational medicine coming into the actual medicine that you're making, that it can also help to support opening up people's minds who maybe have been really stuck in this like westernized left brain, like colonized mindset way of viewing the world of, yeah. You know, and by that, I just mean the fact of like, as if humans and nature are separate, that something like this, it can be helpful to have these bridge experiences to help people come into connection with nature. Cause sometimes it's like, as a society, we can be so steeped in this illusion of separation that sometimes that thick wall of the illusion can be really, really hard to break through. And with something like the Music of the Plants device, I think it's really cool that it allows for a bridge connection that the left brain, that the westernized mind can comprehend of like, wow, there's some electrodes hooked up to this plant. There's a sound coming out of this device. As a result, it sounds completely different from any other plant. And the sound changes the more that you do it, the more that it's hooked up to that plant. Like something is happening there. And like you said, they've been studying this since, I mean, the 70s. But yeah, I think I love that you just brought that up with connecting with the grandkids and helping them open up to the fact that like, yes, that tree does love them. It's amazing.
I have this experience recently that my daughter's boyfriend's dad, very conservative guy, I love him to death. And he wanted to hear the music of the plants. And I hooked up a couple plants in the house. And he goes, you know, if I hadn't seen you do it, I wouldn't have believed it. And here's this older guy, my age, right? Who's not been open to any of this kind of stuff. I took him outside and he asked me to play a tree that was his mother's favorite tree. And when he heard that, it just moved him. And he just was amazed. at that. And that opened him up to newer things, different ideas. Everybody's just like, wow, that's amazing.
That's incredible. That's incredible. Thank you for sharing that. Yeah. I mean, you clearly live your life in such deep service to the plants, to the earth, and this incredible time of transformation that we're in on the planet. And I would love to hear a bit about, you know, how do the plant spirits really support you in your life's work?
Well, healing. I mean, I've had such incredible healing through ceremony, but now it's like adding a new layer. And it gives me joy. I seed my plants. I give offerings before. I put my seeds under a pyramid with the four directions colors that my Congo uncle taught me to do. I play the plant music after I get permission from the seeds. I got to ask permission of the seeds, right? And so we play the music for the seeds in the greenhouse. And then the plants grew stronger this year. Unbelievable, unbelievable, the plants. And I played a lot of Shane's music when I was in there. And I played my own plants music. I took some plants from outside and brought them in, like the rose geraniums, like the rosemary. And they like it. The plants like the music. So I use it and I feel like, okay, like I give away most of the plants because everything I grow from seed grows. And I give it out to community gardens around here and to elders. And the medicine's going out and it's on a new level now with that plant music layer added. And here's some plants that I'll hook up before I'll hook those plants up to the bamboo end before I send them out. So that tomato's playing its own music, that rosemary, that all the different herbs that I grow, the Oregon grape, all of it, it's all going out into the community. And it might be on an unconscious level, but that's okay.
Yeah, it's still happening.
At 9 years old, I was given like 10 gladiola bulbs and they were actually dead. But the neighbor thought, well, I'll just give them to her and she can play around. They all grew. I was 9. They all grew and everyone's looking at me like, oh my gosh, what is that? And I knew because I asked him to please grow. And I made concoctions of flower water and would drink it, not knowing. I was just a kid, you know. I didn't know about flower essences. Who did? Not in America anyway, you know. So it's that whole connection. We grew our own food in the city in Manhattan Beach, California. And I was like the main gardener with my mother, corn, squash, beans, growing in the Three Sisters. My grandmother taught me about plants talking and being more like people, my indigenous grandmother. So it's, you know, it's been with me my whole life. Getting into the cactus plant at 1.5 years old, getting pricked by spines, fast forward to being 21, going to Malibu and harvesting the first wild food I harvested was a prickly pear and I made jelly. So I know that plant infused me at that time. I had that connection. I went out in that field, even though they tried to stop me. I did it anyway. So I feel like that was my beginning.
That's amazing. And you were just sharing as well about how your grandmother introduced you to communicating with plants. Tell us a bit more about that. Like,
my grandma could grow anything, anywhere. Man, that woman was something else. And she had a little garden when she moved in with us. And she used to tell me, you know, the plants talk to you. And it was in the probably early 70s. You know, it was starting to be in the knowledge of people. They were starting to read things in newspapers, no internet then. And she just really believed in that they talked to us. And she told me to listen, you know, and I took that to heart. You know, I took that to heart.
Amazing. Well, Susan, thank you so much for joining us today. This is a conversation I've been looking forward to having for months. And it is just such an incredible honor to have you here joining us. So thank you.
Thank you. It's my honor.
So wonderful. And so to everyone listening, you can find out more about Susan and her work on Instagram at Susina53, or you can actually even just email her directly at Susina53@gmail.com. And those links are in the show notes. Thank you all for joining us. And thanks so much for listening and joining us today on the Plant Spirit Podcast. I hope you enjoyed it, and please follow to subscribe, leave a review, and look forward to seeing you on the next episode.